Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm just giving you a general introduction that in Jesus we have one Father and we are brethren. And our Father is not our Lord, because Lord has slaves. And slaves are not entitled to the royal kingdom of God. They are outside the royal kingdom of God. Whereas the laborers and workers who are the sons of God, they work in the vineyard of God, only they are entitled to inherit the royal kingdom of God. In Jesus, we have one Father. And if you are born white, brown, black, or yellow in different countries, it was not your own choice, but that of our Father. When you know this simple fact of life, then you are no more once born racist or animal, but the twice born of spirit and agape. So, if you are once born, you know, then you will love your people of your own type, own color, because you can only see with two naked eyes. You can't see with the third eye of logical reasoning. So, you are spiritually blind. So, then you hate others who are not of your own type, own color. And once you know that you were born in a white, brown, or yellow color, it was not your choice but that of your Father, then you are twice born. When you are twice born, then the love between you is called agape. Agape is the divine love, and that is the binding force between the brethren in God, or the sons in God, brethren in Christ Jesus. Then people can enter through the narrow gate for the solitary into the royal kingdom of God. So when you are sons of God, you are solitary, and you can enter easily through the narrow gate. You have become solitary because you have come to know of your own self, because nobody can give you this wisdom unless you yourself have it. So you have to make your own effort to know these facts and to become solitary. So then you can pass through a narrow gate for the solitary into the royal kingdom of God, where our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus is found. He is not found outside the royal kingdom of God. He is there inside the royal kingdom of God. So you must enter into this world first. Now he is found. He is the true vine planted by our Father. That means it is the royal kingdom of God, and our Father has planted this true vine, and we have to get ourselves grafted to this one. Though you labor for the fruit of this true vine, this is understanding of gospel parables called eating the flesh of Jesus. So there, you know, you work hard in the vineyard of our Father so that you can be entitled to be grafted to this true vine. And then you can bear fruit, that means preach gospel. So getting grafted to the true vine is also through the understanding of the parables of the gospel. Then when you have understood the parable of the gospel, then you have become capable of or compatible with the true vine. So then becoming compatible to Christ Jesus, who worked for our Father and not for Mammon, as the hireling dog-collar priest work in the organized churches of Mammon. The spiritually blind congregation having so many churches when we have one God and Christ Jesus is the head of the church that is of God. That is one fold, Church of God, one shepherd, Christ Jesus, and the gatekeeper to this fold is Peter, who would not allow a liar into the church. So, you know, in this one, you know, you can see if you come across these people who are put on dog collar, or their deacons are doing any job, you know, in the church. They don't do it unless they are paid. So they are hireling of Mammon. Only the congregation, you know, who go there, they don't get paid. They pay it. They are the paymaster. So they pay into the purse of God. And these people with the dog collar and this and that, they take the money out as their salary, as if they are working for Mammon. So these organization, you know, of the churches which are established, that means the brick-built temple where people go to worship under the command of the priest who has put on a dog collar, showing them that I am the one man of God. But he is not the man of God. He is a hypocrite working for Mammon. That is one fold, Christ, Church of God, one shepherd, Christ Jesus, and the gatekeeper to this fold is Peter, who would not allow a liar. Remember that Peter killed Ananias and Sapphira for telling lies. So if you are a liar, then your foundation is of sand, not of rock. So Peter would not allow anyone who has not a sound foundation into the church. Liars are saltless people that are thrown out into the footpath for people to trample over them. So if there's a church, you know, who establish itself and has a standard as set by Peter, they would not allow a liar into the church. If they find that this man has told lies, a member of the congregation says this man is no good, he told lies, then he will be asked to leave the church. And when he asked to leave the church, then the people outside will ask him, hey, why they push you out? Then he has to tell that he is a liar. That is trampling over the person, over the saltless people. For the love of Mammon and being a thief, saltless Judas Iscariot was thrown out at the Last Supper, a man not properly dressed for the wedding of the Son. Remember, this is sometimes people are arguing these things, you know, that he wasn't the man who was thrown out, and this was confirmed when Jesus gave the parable of the marriage of the Son, where when the Father comes, he finds one man not properly dressed. He said, how dare you come into the banquet not properly dressed? So he was thrown out. You know, these people who worship Mammon, when I tell them he was not properly dressed, they tell me, oh, in those days, you know, the people who used to come for wedding, they were given a special dress, wedding dress, and they were all dressed in that one. So they gave this physical meaning of this wedding dress, you know, not spiritual. So this wedding dress is that when you are not loving Mammon but loving God, then you are dressed in the wedding dress. Son is not the son which you marry in ordinary ways, physical marriage. It is the son Christ Jesus who is celebrating his marriage. That is why he washed the feet of those who were allowed to enter into the bridal chamber or who were attending the banquet. And that was Eucharist, called entering into the bridal chamber. So after the Last Supper, a man not properly dressed for the wedding of the son was Judas Iscariot, and that wedding is celebrated through Eucharist, called entering into the bridal chamber. Christ Jesus welcomed his remaining 11 brides into the house of our Father by washing their feet that walked in the vineyard of our Father, getting the training, you know, and all that. They were the feet who walked through, and they must be tired, you know. So to give them treat, the feet are washed. When you go to somebody's house and they over there, you know, the person will wash your feet so that you don't feel tired anymore. So that's what Jesus did, you know, he washed the feet when those 11 entered into the bridal chamber or enter into the house of our Father. So after baptism, which is the Eucharist, on receiving their wage of Holy Spirit, so when they were baptized, they were sealed to serve God. Baptism is sealing. And remember that Eucharist was not served to the Gentile. It was only meant for the Jewish people. That Ethiopian, which Philip baptized, he baptized in the bridal chamber, that is mean through bread and wine, not by dipping him in water as stated in the Bible. That is Judaized, wrong. So after baptism and on receiving their wage of Holy Spirit at Pentecost, all the 12 set out to preach gospel. That is called drinking the refreshing blood of Christ. Now when you preach gospel, then you are drinking his refreshing blood of Christ, that is renewing your inner man every day. Thus hireling are those who work for Mammon, hireling hypocrites who work for Mammon and not for God. They have nothing in common with our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus. That is, they are not compatible with him. Remember, John the Baptist wasn't a hireling. They both took to wilderness and they worked for God our Father, not for any Mammon. So if you want to be compatible with Christ Jesus, then please do not get paid in Mammon. Only people like the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person who did not expect repayment could be grafted to the true vine. So this Samaritan man presented ideal person that could be grafted to the true vine. But the Jewish people, they hate Samaritans because they loved darkness. That is why Jesus in John's Gospel says, the light came among his own, but his own hated light, because it exposes their hypocrisy, and they loved darkness. And that's how they killed the apostles, these messianic Jews. When they entered the church, then they killed the apostles by putting them before animals and all burning at stake. This has been going on since 15th century. So my services are totally free, and let us preach gospel from the rooftops. Watch my over 2,260 YouTube videos on Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and my channel is Nijjar One. So Christ Jesus, about the second anointed Christ, said, as lightning strikes in the east, flashes towards the west. The light is there, the religious light which I am giving you, but it doesn't shine in India. But in India, anyone who wants to do anything, he first of all seeks Mammon, and then he seeks his own praises, that this man is a very good this and that, but they are not there to glorify our Father, but to glorify themselves. Even some of them, they charge money for singing the gospel, and they are the what we call the headmen of the most holiest of holy place, that is in Amritsar, where the golden temple is. There is a throne called Akal Takht. Akal means eternal throne of God. They are sitting there, and they charge money, Mammon. So they are the most crooked people that you can come across in the world. So those temple rabbis in the time of Jesus, they were babies or nothing as compared with what we have in India. So Christ Namik Devi was the second anointed coming of Jesus. You don't need to believe me unless you know these things through your own effort. That is what this Samaritan woman did after she had identified Christ, Jesus as the Christ or the prophet. And then when she went to the town, she did not say that, "Hey, I have found the Christ." She said, "No, I have found the person, but go and test it yourself." That means you have to vet it yourself. Nobody can pass gospel from one person to the other. This is demonstrated that in the Roman Catholic Church, and one of the Roman Catholic, I was attending the annual conference at Woodcourt near Reading. And this year I wanted to attend it, but they said, "No, I can't attend it because I criticize them, you know." So over there, this one of the priests said, "You can't pour the Eucharist wine from one cup into the other." Then I asked him why. He had no idea. Eucharist wine is the blood of Christ, and blood of Christ is gospel. Remember that the flesh of Jesus is understanding the parables. When you preach gospel, then you are drinking the blood of Christ. So you can't preach gospel unless you have Christ in your heart. So this Christ is received by the grace of our Father. And when you receive it, then you are ordained by our Father and not by men, as these dog-colored people are ordained. They work for Mammon, and they are ordained by those who worship Mammon. That means the university professors and other things, they get hefty salaries. What? They say they are working for God, preaching gospel and this and that. No, they are teaching the letters, dead letters to the students. So our Father God bless you.